Mic check, 1, 2, 1, 2, mic check, hello, hoo-ah. How now, brown, how, blah. Vocal exercise, warm-ups, red leather, yellow leather, blah, blah, blah. All right, let's get this show cracking. Everybody ready? Can I get cameramen on camera? Thank you, our hosts are all mic'd up, I believe. We're good to go, okay. Teleprompter is up and going, we don't need another fuck-up of glass time. All right, we're good. All right, everyone, let's make this happen then, team. We are going into season 5, episode 1. Let's make this a good one. Do we have the intro all queued up and ready to go? It's good to go. All right, make intro go in 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Make intro go now. Party people up in the place to be. Thank you for joining me, your host, Dave Koval. Welcome. It is season 5 premiere of Dave Controls the Airwaves. I'm excited to be doing this again. I took a little bit of a break, but we're back. We are back. This is Dave Controls the Airwaves. I am your host, AVJ Dave. Yeah, we are here, as you can see, in the brand spanking new studios. Look at this lovely Dave Koval Comedy Channel studios. You know, they were going to trash it, and I said, no, I'll go film a show there, and they're like, okay. That's that story. Guys, thank you for hanging out with me. We are streaming live. We are on Facebook. We are on YouTube. We're on Twitch. Say what the fuck's up in the comments, and maybe I'll be like, yo, what the fuck's up? Big shout out to Anya. Big shout out to Hanouf. Everybody tune in watching. Big shout out to Dunks Johnson, who's trying to talk shit in the Twitch room. We don't play like that. If you don't want to hang out, you don't have to. But I know you in real life, and you're a good guy. Brogan. So let's get this show going. If I have any new watchers who weren't around last season, basically the rundown of the show is this. During the pandemic 2 years ago, I was like, I want to watch comedy with my friends. And guess what? That's what I started doing. I started streaming comedy, and then I'm like, it's funner if I go on camera because I'm kind of entertaining at times. And so I started doing that, and then here we are 2 years later, season 5. Don't do the math on that. It works somehow. We're hanging out and we're watching comedy. I have handpicked delightful short-form sketch comedy for you guys. I've got some fun web shows, some fun shit I pulled off of YouTube and College Humor and Funny or Die and Crack.com. All those fun locations, wherever you go for your... Well, I mean, nowadays everyone goes to TikTok and they go to Instagram, but we don't do vertical videos on this show. Though I might have to change that policy if I want to keep a fan base younger than 40. All right. Cool. Thank you guys for jamming in with me today. We have a very fun show. Oh no, I forgot to do the big season 5 logo. I just love how annoying that noise is. We have a lot of fun segments we're going to do today. We're going to take a look back at the first show I ever did. Which, trust me, it's a little embarrassing, but, you know, no one's great at anything first time out the gate, or unless you're a robot. We're also going to be looking at my big day out. And guess what? Yep, we're bringing it back. It's the top 10 list. So that's gonna be fun. all right. Momentum. Keep the momentum going, Dave. Keep talking. Pretend like you've done this before. Dunks Johnson agrees that fuck a vertical vid, and if you didn't know I was a robot by now, like, you've been in my house, Dunks, so you should have figured it out. This is always the thing, like, I stream this on Facebook and YouTube, and I get, well, maybe not YouTube, you don't have to use your real name. Anyways, Facebook, I know who I'm talking to, and then you get these guys coming on Twitch with their clever handles and their funny avatars, and then I'm just like, there's a guy, and he's my friend, probably, and he plays basketball, and that's like two people. But anyways, I figured out who you are, and also you've watched there before. Anyways, tell your friends to come watch me be stupid. We're gonna watch comedy. Why don't I start things off with the first playlist? We got a bunch of them. I got like four playlists going tonight. We're gonna jump back and forth between me doing bits and funny videos. There's the rundown, and everybody who's watching has seen me before, let's be honest. We are gonna be watching some fun sketches in this first little segment. I'll tell you what we're going to watch. We're gonna watch something from John Benjamin. We got a classic sketch from Tim and Eric. We got something from Cream. Not the band, idiot. We got a couple sketches from The Birthday Boys. Although I know Marina's the biggest Birthday Boys fans, and she's at trivia right now. So I hope you're watching this on a repeat later and you feel shame for missing my comeback, even though I probably didn't tell you until a couple days ago. We got a new sketch from Auntie Donna. And we got something from Scott Gardner. He's a funny boy. All right, so we're going to go and... I guess we're just going to go and watch some of those videos now. And we're doing longer segments. I'm back to 15-minute video segments like I did, like, first season for the Long Hangers Honors. So I'll see y'all in 15 minutes. Let's cut to that playlist. A 5, a 4, a 3, a 2, and the 1.
Tonight on John Benjamin Has a Van, we'll visit with this soldier and hear his incredible story. And on tonight's exclusive interview, our exclusive interview with reclusive Guatemalan drug lord El Manta Blanca. And another installment of OCD After Dark. All this and more on tonight's John Benjamin Has a Van.
This is you can't shoot here. So, the show you can't shoot here.
I'm sorry.
This is the show you can't shoot here. We're here to shoot video for the show you can't shoot here.
Okay.
Okay. So we just. I'll just walk around.
Let me get my. Because you're not allowed to shoot.
And right. I know. Hi. We're with you can't shoot here.
Who?
You can't shoot here. We're with the show you can't shoot here. We're just gonna shoot in the lobby.
No, unfortunately, you can't.
You can't what?
You can shoot it here. Because you can't use, sir. Excuse me.
Hi, sir.
Oh,
sorry.
Well, we were explaining that we're on the show. You can't shoot here. That's why.
No, you can't shoot here.
All you have to do is sign the form, and we shoot here, and then you're on the show. You can't shoot here.
You cannot shoot here.
Can you shoot video in here?
Carol?
No, we
Benji?
Can't.
Just tell her we'll shoot in the place. Just tell her we'll shoot around. We're just shooting around.
We can't shoot there.
We're shooting in places where you can't shoot, and we already got it, so we're done.
Well.
We're doing the show. I'm sorry, you're in a meeting. It's
yes,
silly to.
But you can't do this.
No filming in the store.
It's a nice spot.
I mean, thanks for being on You Can't Shoot Here.
Are you ready, kids? Do-do-do-do! Now slap your hands. Now spread those wings. Do-do-do-do. Feather your bangs. Shake your buns. That's nice. Now think about your dad. What's your dad like? I want to meet that dad. Slap your face. Slap your friend. Get sexy, kids. Do-do-do-do. Stinks in here. Smells like meat. Rotten meat. Kids, why would you bring that rotten meat in here of all places? Kids, you stupid motherfuckers. What the hell's wrong with you, kids? Kids, you gotta keep your meat ice cold. I know you like your bologna soft, but if it gets too warm, it's gonna spoil and start to stink the place up. And I know you don't want that. So come on, do it for me. Keep that meat cool. And chill out.
Do you need shots of ordinary people doing things for your next commercial? We got that B-roll.
We got that B-roll.
Two men pointing at an office file? We got that B-roll. Bored man flipping through channels? We got that B-roll. Angry man in traffic? Yeah, we got that B-roll. What do you want him to wear? Casual? Upscale casual? Business? We got that B-roll. Why does he look so upset? Maybe he's late for work. Nope, he's at work. He's a B-roll actor. Happy couple walking on the beach? We got that B-roll. Want that happy couple to kiss? No problem. Want him to get a little fresh with the lady? Done. Hey, you two, cut it out and stay at the ocean so I can get B-roll of that. That's better. What a nice view of the ocean. That's B-roll of the ocean. Think that's all the B-roll we got? Not even close. Overwhelmed man trying to pay bills? Yeah, we got it. Frustrated man looking for a job in the paper? You know we got it. And lunch meeting success. Hey, look, that's me. I like my B-roll so much I'm in it. Kirk Gibson hitting a game-winning home run in the 88 World Series. No! That's too specific. That is not B-roll. Doctor talking to smiling patient. We got that B-roll. Man having trouble sleeping. Got it. What's his problem? He doesn't like being in B-roll? I was just in some B-roll and I loved it. The sneezer. Backache. Headache. And depressed woman touching a wall. Why is she touching the wall? I don't know. That's what depressed people do, right? Don't judge the B-roll. Listen, we got all that B-roll and thousands more. So come on down to our B-roll warehouse. Just kidding. That's B-roll. I fooled you, see? That's how good our B-roll is. We got that B-roll.
We got that B-roll.
You know we do.
To order your B-roll, call 1-800-BBB-ROLL. That's 1-800-BBB-ROLL. Call now.
Rock City Soundscape burst onto the scene 3 years ago with their eponymous indie label debut. The lo-fi LP blew up and landed them on major pop records, where they released their sophomore effort, Dancing. The album was heavily promoted and licensed to national commercial. But their new pop sound was met with scorn from fans.
They suck! Sellouts!
And when sales faltered, the band opted for a new direction. Turning their backs on the pop music industry, they spent 10 months in a cabin outside of Eau Claire, Wisconsin.
You don't need a fancy studio to make an album, you know? You don't need electricity. You don't need running water. You don't need toilets to make an album. You just need music.
Enduring severe weather and isolation, they finally emerged with what they've described as their most personal work to date. An untitled triple album recorded entirely on analog reel-to-reel. And now, the world's premiere of the album's opening track, The Woods.
Woods, woods, we're in the woods. We hope this single gets a lot of downloads. Woods, woods, we're
Boys, hello. Welcome to come in.
Thank you.
Wow.
Oh my god.
Welcome to the Dargie House. Designed by prominent mid-century architect Alastair Knox.
Oh, wow.
This space is a beautiful example of the mid-century mud brick bungalow. Now, let me say, I am just house-sitting.
Yeah.
But for this weekend, this is my home. Uh-huh. And mi casa, su casa.
This is nice. I love this.
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. And I love the books. And we've got here the master bedroom.
What's
and
this, Bubba? Like, what's this?
I maybe don't.
Well, put it back.
They didn't mention the books in the email. Or...
Yeah, a bit of respect.
Sorry. I didn't
absolutely
realize.
Listen to Brendan, man. And that's just... Oh.
I think that might be a sculpture. I'm not confident that that's a chair.
Hey, it's your casa, my casa, right? So
yeah. It's
all
good.
Yeah, but...
Thanks for the glasses of water.
Thanks, Zach. Cheers.
So I was looking at the NASDAQ and it's not good news.
Well, I don't know what NASDAQ is, so, like, and I've said that to you before because you talked to me about it, but...
What's in here? Oh, nice.
Yeah, but now it's time to relax. Okay, let's chuck on the television.
Have you got like a little needle?
Yeah.
Get a needle and press the reset.
Oh, just hit the reset, yeah.
Hold that. Is it? What? That's not a remote.
So, you've got... Ah, oh, you spilled some water.
Ares mirabilis non tuca.
I press this thing so fucking hard it doesn't actually go in as much as it was going in before.
So think of the NASDAQ as a place where you can...
In regards to the modem, it is fucked.
Because I fucking did a number on this thing, man.
We broke this vase, by the way. We broke this, by the way. Wow, you got yourself a pretty sweet dig here, Zach.
Yes, I do. And all I got to do is check the mail and feed the cat.
Oh, there's a cat?
Yes, there is. Cat got your tongue. That's a little thing we say here in the homeowner business. I bumped into the neighbour up that way. I bumped into him. I didn't know what to say. He said, cat got your tongue. I said, oh, that's a good phrase. Look that up. That just means you don't know what to say. It's a little thing we say here in Warrandyte.
Mr. Biden, how does the president make a law?
Oh, that's not how worse can't be done.
But if most people want something, shouldn't it be a law?
Look, the president doesn't have a magic wand. Doesn't have a wand. Right? No wand.
But if one party controls three branches of government...
No, come on. That's... Your mom and dad got a vote.
They did.
Your mom... This fall, vote is on the ballot.
What?
Vote is on the ballot. Come on.
Why aren't you singing?
That's not how it works. No magic wand, make the president sing. Come on, vote.
I have to vote now?
Yeah.
For what?
Vote.
Can you make a law?
Give me $20, I'll read you a poem.
And finally, a story that will warm your heart, local kid Jared McIntyre is normal in every way except one. He's autistic. As the student assistant for Johnson High School basketball team, he came to every practice and suited up for every game, but never left the bench.
tower.
All that changed, however, in the final moments against rivals Liberty High, when Coach Granger signaled Jared to get in the game.
Well, Jared has a lot of heart, you know. We were down by a bunch of points with like 3 minutes left, so I figured, what the heck, give the kid a shot.
What happened next shocked everyone. On his first play in, Jared hit a perfect three-pointer and the crowd went crazy. But Jared wasn't done. In the next 2 minutes, he followed that up with a second three-pointer. Sunk two free throws and then made eight more three-pointers. He even attempted a slam dunk, which he made, leading his team to a crushing 37-point victory.
I just did what I thought was right, you know. The kid deserved a chance. I mean, forget how the game turned out. He inspired everyone.
He had autism? Well, how do we get some of that from my players? He crushed us. He crushed our spirits. You let the kid have his moment. Now, get him out. Put him in the locker room. Let him do the laundry or whatever he does.
Yeah, everybody loves Jared. It's great to see him make those shots. Why doesn't he play more?
Jared graduates this year, and a roving college recruiter was shown tapes of him at work. We asked about the super kid's chances of playing college ball, and he had this to say.
Well, Jared's got a big heart, a ton of heart, and he hits every single three-pointer clean. It's insane. But, no. He can't play college ball. I mean, because of the autism, he couldn't handle the course load.
But Jared gets straight A's, and he's in AP Math and Science.
Huh. Well, there you go.
I don't know. When he joined the team, I was told that he was autistic, so I guess I thought that I shouldn't. I don't know. I just thought he was special, so I should let him play less, or maybe I should let him play more. I don't know. I'm a substitute coach.
So let's hear it for Local 7's Kid of the Week, Substitute Coach Granger.
All right, party people, we are back once again. I hope you enjoyed all that funny shit I just played for you. And if you didn't, that's your problem, bud. All right, let's keep this show moving right on forward. It's time for the first hosted segment. And today we're looking back at the first show. Ah, yes, I remember it fondly. The day was March. No. When did the pandemic hit? When did everything close down? That was like March 14th or something. Anyways, it was roughly in like May-ish or something like that. And I was sitting at home and I'm like, I'm going to try this thing. And, you know, it wasn't May. It was like June. Anyways, So, you know, the first time doing something, you're not always amazing at it, and everyone knows that, and so it took me some time to hit, but I think if you look back, you'll see there was a nugget of talent in me that has blossomed into the wonderful performer I am today. Let's go take a purse back at the fucking first show, Bing Bang Boogity Boom. Oh, we're on the air. Hi, hello, everyone. Welcome to the, first episode of Dave Controls the Airwaves. This is a new show that I'm gonna start doing every week from live from the Toronto City University campus dorm production studio. And I've never really been on camera much before. But they were looking for student volunteers to be on on-air hosts, and so I thought I can do that. And so here I am, and I had an idea for fun that we could hang out together and watch some funny comedy videos, and I could do some fun bits here. So first of all, I should introduce myself. My name's VJ Dave. That's my name. That's a name key. What we call in the biz a lower third, is that's what we call that graphic. Yeah, let's we should. Oh. So, whoops. There's just so much junk piled up in this room. This is a very small room. I don't have a lot of. Jesus Christ, my leg!
Oh, you, fuck.
What are you doing? Hey, get back here! Where are you going? Yeah, so, you know, it took me a little while to get used to the show, but that was episode one. Yeah. So, let's keep this show moving forward. Keep that momentum, Dave. Keep that momentum going. We got plenty of great stuff coming up for you. Let's talk about the next playlist that we're gonna do. Let me see what we got lined up for you. This will be the Channel 101 segment. Channel 101 is a fun, creative website where people have been making dumb sketch and web shows for years and years and years. They'll make an episode of it, they have a screening, and if people vote for your show and they like it, then you get to do another episode. So I'm gonna give you a little sampling, for anybody who might be new tonight, of kind of what Channel 101 is. It's basically, have a dumb idea, go shoot it, go make it. No budget, who gives a fuck? Just have fun and make something dumb, and you know, these guys that I'm about to show you were very entertaining, because we're going to be watching the following episodes. We're going to be watching The Jogger. We're going to be watching Goo Gahs, and then we're going to be watching a very fun show called Commercial Break. So we're going to go watch that, we're going to have some fun, and we're going to come back and do more things with Dave. Sound good? Well, that's what we're doing, even if it doesn't. All right, let's cut to this in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
My name's Dan, and I like to jog. Jogging's a great way to get some exercise. And when you're jogging, you never quite know who you're gonna meet or how you can help.
Excuse me, I think you dropped this.
Oh, thank you very much.
My dog is running in the street.
Whoa.
Come here, you little scamp. It's okay, I got him.
Oh, thank you so much. Just put him on the curb.
Stay.
My kite won't fly.
Let me give it a try.
Hey, thanks, mister.
Sure thing. Excuse me, I couldn't help notice you're crying. Is it jogging related?
No, of course not. No, I just found out my husband was killed. I got so distraught, I thought I'd go for a jog.
Well, jogging is a great way to relieve stress.
I know. My name is Lori. Thank you for your compassion.
Dan, you know, I'm not a detective, but I know a thing or two about life and people. Do you mind if I take a look at the crime scene?
No, I think I'd like that.
I think something's happened to your husband. I think he's been murdered.
Murdered? Dan. Oh, Dan, I'm afraid.
It's all right.
I'm so very afraid.
Keep your feet moving. Nothing can harm you. Drop back to an 11-minute mile. I'm going to have a frank discussion with the chief of police.
Thank you.
Good morning, chief.
Yeah, who the fuck are you?
This concerned jogger. Is that the evidence you got there?
Huh? Yeah, I'm just driving it very slowly to the lab. You got a fucking problem with that?
Not at all. Any suspects?
Just one. Found him at the murder scene. But he's not saying anything. And we're letting him jog and see if that helps.
Mind if I have a word with him?
What the fuck do I care?
Howdy. Heck of a day for a jog.
Yeah, you said it.
Sorry about your friend back there. You jog much?
I'm training for the marathon. 26 miles.
Marathons are 26.2 miles. A jogger would know that. A killer wouldn't. Feeling right there is called a stitch. From the Latin to stick. You're going through a process called lactic acid buildup. Any good jogger would know that. But not a killer. Never a killer. Take away, Chief. He's the killer.
Thanks!
Endorphins are my thanks, my dear. But you're welcome.
I'll call you after the funeral.
Yep, the open road is full of adventure. And sometimes, even love.
Help! My husband's having a heart attack.
Thanks for the jump!
And as long as you take life in stride, things always seem to work out.
I still can't believe our parents are dead.
Well, they left us this big house.
Hey Justin, what did you find over there?
I don't know. Ominous?
I don't think you should read it out loud, because...
Dominus!
Justin, don't read that.
Don't keep reading that. It's got a fucking pentagram on it.
For the love of God, stop reading!
Justin, I mean, come on.
What the hell are these crazy... Googas? Right? That's what we're gonna call them?
I'll tell you one thing, we gotta call the cops, we gotta call the army. I mean, this is like Ghoulies out there.
What if the cops come and hurt him? What if this is not like Ghoulies, but it's like Alf?
Alf was adorable, this is Ghoulies!
This is like Alf.
Ghoulies!
Guys, we're like Party of Five. Our parents died, they left us this beautiful house. Fuck those guys, right? Fuck those little creatures. It has nothing to do with those guys. It has to do with the five of us.
You're the fucking black sheep of this family.
Oh, fuck.
We got creatures living out in the room. You sitting here babbling about, what are you talking about?
Guys, right now it's like M. Night Shyamalan's The Happening. Because we don't know what the fuck is going on. We need to know if those things are good or evil.
We want to know if you're good.
Get off me! All right, maybe these Googas aren't like Alf, but that doesn't mean that they're from hell like the Ghoulies.
Justin, even if they're like critters, even if they're from outer space, they're still a threat to humanity that needs to be eliminated.
But what if they're not all the same? What if they're like gremlins or munchies?
All right, well, you know what, Kelsey? Some of us haven't seen munchies!
I haven't seen Ghoulies, all right?
Oh, guys. Munchies, Ghoulies, critters. I mean, our parents are dead. We're like Party of Five.
All right, Mike's right. We're never gonna know how to deal with these Googas until we stop arguing with each other and we just start renting some of these movies.
She's a good girl, loves her mama, loves Jesus,
And America, too. She's a good girl.
Look, it's clear there's a 76% chance that these goo-gahs are evil.
Yeah,
with a 49% chance that they only act in self-defense. So stop trying to make us all scared, like Pierce Brosnan in Dante's Peak. You keep it up, and I'm gonna become like the black man in Cube. We've got two choices. We can sit around, get picked off one by one like the people in Alien, or we can fight back like the people in Aliens.
Have a great vacation, play some great tennis, and then let's move into Mom and Dad's house together and be the happiest family that ever lived, huh?
I love you guys.
We won. It's just like Rocky.
Rocky? Or Schindler's List?
Guys, there's something I can't figure out.
What's that, Kelsey?
With the Goo-Gahs dead, what is it gonna be like around here?
It'll be like Party of Five.
It's a shame. He would have liked it.
Bro! It's the Goo-Gah that came out of his chest!
Hey, who wants to go play some cards?
What?
it's like elves!
E.T.! It's like E.T.!
Five. Ooh, oh, with a little hint of Jackass. I think this could be a pretty good show.
Well, what can I say? You know, I did my best, made it to the final four, but they gave me the heart transplant, and I'm a brain surgeon, so. My heart goes out to the patient's family, but I didn't come here to make friends. Okay. I came here to play the game. I think what it comes down to at the end of the day is just knowledge. I've never really seen the inside of a person before, other than the top of their head. So, best of luck, guys. And watch out, Mark. This Capek's a bitch.
What is a car? Is it the rims? Or the headlight area? Or is it the motors, or these red wires? Maybe you can't define what a car is because no one's ever seen a car. Maybe a car is an idea. Maybe a car is inside us. Maybe we are a car. Yeah. Yeah. I like that. Okay.
Toast. Move. Hold my drink. God, Dick. What's your name? Where's my car? As your reference.
Says tomorrow's gonna be hotter.
Hotter?
like yesterday.
Yesterday? Yesterday you said you'd call Sears.
I'll call today.
Now's the time to save on Sears installed central home air conditioning. Call now for a free in-home estimate.
Yo, yo. Drunk dick in the house!
Get this party started.
Now that's what's dancing, America.
And we're back. Well, there you go. Some fun shit from over the years of Channel 101. You can see the range in quality, but the laughs keep coming all the way through. Guys, welcome back to Dave Controls Airwaves. We are, of course, having our Season 5 premiere. And it's a ton of fucking fun. We're going to keep things just moving on along, because it's 9:45. We're only halfway through the show. So today I actually had a really fun day. I got to hang out with some good friends of mine that I hadn't seen in a while, and they basically told me, they're like, Dave, it's your big day, you're having a big special day, and we're going to have a great fun time, but they didn't tell me what it was, but I went and filmed all day because I was a little excited. Let's take a look at my big day out.
Hey, what's up, guys? I just woke up. I'm so excited today. My friends are going to take me on a big day out, they told me, and they didn't tell me what it was, but I know what it is, and I'm so excited. Big day out. It's an exciting one.
Oh yeah, big day out. Huge day out. I'm fucking excited.
So excited. Big day out. Big day out. Well, I'm here. I'm so excited. It's my big day out. I'm about to meet my friends and oh, right, I gotta change first. Well, guys, I'm so excited!
You made it!
Yeah, we're, what is this?
It's medieval times.
I thought you guys were taking me to FurryCon.
Wait, why would you think that?
You never listen.
That was my big day out. That is a lot of fun. I've never done medieval times before. Certainly not in a squirrel suit or whatever the hell I was. A skunk? I don't even know what I was. I already forgot what the bit was. Anyways, let's go check in on the stream, see who's saying stuff. Nobody's saying anything. Well, that's fine. I know you're watching. I know your eyes are on me, and that's the important thing. Boom, boom, baba, shidala, boom, shaboom. Let's keep the show moving forward. Up next, this segment is the web show of the week. This one's a fun one. It's called New Partner. And basically, God, do I need to give away the premise, or do they give it away in the first few minutes? I think I'll just, I'll tell you who made it. Quinn Beswick and Josh Margolin, two real funny guys. And this is a web series. It's like a 3-episode series they did for Funny or Die a while ago. And it also works as a short film, because it's a kind of a constant narrative. But it's a lot of fun. It's real fucking funny. And if you like this series, you should also check out, there's a great movie they did called Deep Murder, where it's basically, the plot is, it's like a really crappy softcore cable porn movie, and then a murder happens, and the characters are too stupid and one-dimensional to know what to do when a murder happens, because they're just bad acting porn stars. So that's a good premise for you. That's not what we're watching right now. We're watching New Partner, and this is about a cop who keeps running into trouble. Poor guy. It's not his lucky day. All right, we're going to a New Partner, and we'll be back in 15 or so. Counting down 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and then go playlist.
Fuck! Fuck!
This is Officer Ron Robinson. I repeat, officer down, officer down.
Officer Robinson, what?
Ah! Fuck, Robinson. What the hell is wrong with you?
I told you, I work better alone.
That's 3 partners dead this week. It's fucking Tuesday. If you weren't People Magazine's number one cop in America, I swear to God, Ron.
You know, I keep asking you to take that down.
Well, I never will. That was a great day in the history of this precinct. You and your partner there, God rest his soul, saved a lot of lives that day.
Joey was my best friend, and I threw him under the bus.
Well, that bus was carrying a lot of musically gifted children.
You should have let all those kids die.
I'm gonna sign you a new partner.
Oh, God damn it, Captain. Please, I keep telling you, I'm like singles tennis. I don't make any sense with a partner.
You're better than this. You're just in a rut right now. I'm gonna help you get out of it. Hey, Scraps, bring those limp little noodles you call legs in here. Don't worry about the door. Sorry.
Huh?
It's okay.
Oh, Robinson, I like your suspenders.
Well, I didn't want you to be the only heartthrob in this precinct.
Stop. So I got your new partner right here. He's a local boy. Little slow on the uptake, but very good in the field.
I'm only asking one thing, Robinson.
What's that, Captain?
Just don't get him killed.
Partners in crime. Stopping. You know, I don't think that we had a proper introduction. I'm Officer...
Oh, I don't want to know your name.
Why not?
Just makes it harder.
You know, I think I could probably really help you. You know, I grew up in this neighborhood. I lost my V-card on that corner right there.
That's great.
Yeah. I don't get discounts on phones anymore. They have this no replacement card policy. I think it's stupid. I have to just give them my phone number whenever I go. It's very inconvenient, you know, because I grew up in this neighborhood for a long time, and so I have my childhood number.
Sure.
My mother's no longer with us, so it's like this constant reminder, you know?
We've got a 507 at 1428 Washington Boulevard.
Thank you, Barbara. Car 12 is en route. Buckle up.
A guinea pig in the basement, otherwise I'm not gonna feed it.
From one lawman to another, do your fucking job. I almost ran over those two chicks. You know what I should do? I should write you up. But instead, I'm gonna let you off with a warning. No phones.
Did you hear that? Did you hear what happened? It was a cop.
Thank you.
Tatch over at Vallejo, but this ain't like the shit you've seen on Rookie Blue.
I've never seen Rookie Blue.
Oh, you gotta see it.
Good?
Yeah, it's on ABC.
Oh, I gotta see it.
Well, oink oink, motherfuckers.
If I were not a cop, I would shoot you in the fucking face.
Hey, who's this little cream puff?
Sir, we received some complaints that you were being a nuisance.
You trying to tell me I can't go around playing my little fun bongo drummer, boy? You trying to tell me I can't squeeze a lady's titties on the street anymore?
No, sir, you can't. You never could. Is that right?
What?
No?
Never.
Okay. You can't do it.
No.
You said it.
Okay.
All right, so we're going to have to take you in, okay?
Not before I teach you two little piggies a lesson.
Watch your neck, watch your neck. There you go.
That's it.
Learn from the best. That's you. You're the best.
Thank you. Now, you're all right, kid. Why don't you, run over to 7-Eleven, buy yourself a Slurpee or something? You earned it.
Thank you, sir.
What's your name?
Ray Gonzalez Jr., sir.
Ray Gonzalez Jr. All right.
Partners.
It's my new partner. Hey, partner! Don't forget my change, huh? What? Oh, fuck.
Oh, fuck. Fuck. Oh, my. Are you still there? I think I hit a cat.
Fuck. Oh, shit. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Oh, fuck. Ah! Why? Why? Why do you keep doing this? Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. Oh, son of a bitch!
I'm giving you a new partner.
You son of a bitch!
You son of a bitch! I'm sorry.
Just fire me.
I'm not gonna fire you, Ron. Stop asking me. Well, just cheer up, okay? This guy's a little different.
Different like he's got a ponytail, or different like he's Chinese, or what?
What? Neither. He's an actor. He's researching a role.
Who we got, Scraps?
Just a little some guy named Frankie Coppola.
Are you telling me there is another Coppola?
He's a distant Coppola.
There's a lot of Coppolas.
Come on, he played that scientist in Jurassic Park.
Jurassic Park? Is that disaster movie set at Six Flags?
Yeah.
Yeah, no. I am not gonna drive around some foofy actor. He won't last a day out there.
That's why I'm telling you to just turn your radio off, okay? If a call comes in, just ignore it.
What?
Just take the day off, okay? Drive the guy around, let him feel like he's a real cop, even though he's not a real cop, he's just a fucking actor, and just keep him out of trouble.
It sounds like a lot of fun to me, Ron. I wish I could go with you guys, but I can't because my legs are mush.
I will do my best.
Sometimes your best isn't good enough.
Well, then, what do you want me to do?
Oh, just do your best.
Thank you, that's what I'm saying.
Jesus Christ.
Fucking Christ.
Man, it is so real out here. The people. The smells.
That's those veggie dogs I got at that truck. Guy puts like aioli on them. You can get one for like $10.
Can I hold your gun?
No, you're not allowed.
Yeah. Listen. I want to thank you for bringing me into your world. I want this to be a safe space. Where I can share, and you can share, and we can grow.
Okay, but I am pretty sure I stopped growing when I was 18.
I see a lot of pain behind those eyes.
I don't think so.
Yeah. Yeah, loss. You've suffered great loss. Immense pain.
Nuh-uh.
Yeah. Yeah. Huh. Let me in.
Oh, fuck you, you acting piece of shit! With your pretend life and your movies and your magic! Fuck you! You don't understand me at all! At all.
Breathe. You understand me completely.
Go on.
Next was Gonzalez. She's a sweet, you know, dumb kid. Got hit by a car.
It was Tuesday?
Today's Wednesday. Yeah. It was Tuesday.
Well, thank you for telling me your story. You know, you so remind me of my good friend and distant cousin, Nick Cage.
Nick Cage is a Coppola?
We're all Coppolas. Some of us just don't realize it yet.
So, enough about me. You know, tell me about this movie you're doing.
Well, it's about a cop named a Bastard Phelps. He sells his soul to the devil in exchange for some hellish weapons to hunt his wife's killer. It's called Lethal Weapons.
Wow, sounds very exciting.
Oh, it will be. We got this hot young director.
Wow.
Soon as he graduates junior high, he's going to have all summer to make the movie.
Wow. So how does it end?
It's a big, big showdown between Bastard and the devil at an abandoned meth lab.
R-rated. Don't take your kids. Well, I hate to break it to you. You know, there's just not a lot of days like that on the beat.
Car 12, we've got an explosion at a meth lab downtown. A guy dressed like the devil has an AK-47 and he's opened fire. This Bastard's out of his mind. Please respond.
What are you doing?
I gotta keep you out of harm's way. You're new, man.
I was new, man, but I'm ready. You've taught me so much.
You don't understand. This thing, it's like a giant. It's bigger than us, Frankie.
I do understand. Trust me. I'm your best friend.
Do you have a packed heat? Partner?
Actually...
Where's your gun? I don't know about this.
Captain, it's the most impressive file I've ever seen. If anyone can get Robinson back on track, she can.
I hear you giving me a bitch for a partner!
Keep your voice down! Shut the door! Jesus Christ!
You know that I did not take a girl to my senior prom because I didn't want to look gay in front of all my friends. Hey, Scraps, can I ask you a question? Does this photo look gay to you?
Yeah.
No. This is one of my best friends in the world, Chuck Haggerty, and if he were not on Fire Island with his buddy Jake right now, he would tell you how not get... Oh, my God, Chuck.
Ron, you're getting a new partner. Just try to keep an open mind about it. I really think she can teach you a thing or two.
About what? How to cook a...
Don't you dare say something offensive. My daughter is a woman.
Today is going to be so gay.
For the record, I think your daughter is a beautiful woman.
Keep out of this.
Okay.
Oh, God. Oh, my God.
McGiddy's just confessed and ratted on Van Dyna. That's 7 arrests today, which is almost a personal best, so thank you for your help.
I didn't really do anything, but...
It's 3:45 p.m., shades drawn, no visual confirmation of contraband, no sign of life.
The sky is blue, bees make honey, I just farted, and if you're gonna be any closer to that tape recorder, you might as well just kiss it.
Officer Robinson?
I'm just making a point here, Barbara.
Look. I've been tracking Van Dyna for 3 months now. Every move he makes is calculated. And according to all 7 testimonies, the strongest heroin in the city is in that house.
So you're saying he's got Katniss Everdeen in there? Because I can't think of a heroine stronger than her. You seen the way she shoots all those hot kids? The way she's got to choose between the little weird guy and the big sexy guy?
Why are you making a joke out of everything I say?
I don't know. Why did the chicken cross the road?
What's wrong with you?
Maybe I woke up on the wrong side of the bed this morning. Or maybe you are the first woman I've ever worked with, definitely the best cop I've ever seen, and I am incredibly intimidated by you. You ever thought of that, you dumb bitch? I'm sorry. I didn't wake up on the wrong side of the bed this morning. It was the second part. And you're not a dumb bitch.
You really think I'm the best cop you've ever seen? Well, I think you've got a pretty little mustache.
You are the strongest woman I have ever met.
And you are not as heavy as you think.
God, you're twice the cop that I am, that I'll ever be.
Well, don't say that. I wouldn't have asked to be your partner if I didn't think you still had it.
You asked to be my partner?
Well, of course I did.
Now I see. No, it's not gay to be with a woman.
Listen, partners, both sex ones and professionals, need to work as a team. You get my back, I got yours. Deal?
That's a deal.
Okay.
Partner.
I was literally just talking about you. What are the odds? How are you?
I'm great. I just got back from Fire Island. It was so fun. Mai Tais, hot guys.
So Chuck, are you gay?
Yeah.
So when we went to prom together, did you think that was a date?
Of course I did. You bought me a corsage.
Listen, Chuck, I am sorry if I led you on. That was not my intention, but I have met this girl. And she is just... Oh, shit!
Goodbye, Ron Robinson.
Hey, come here. You're right. There you are.
You're a terrible partner.
What?
And an even worse boyfriend.
No. Hey. Yeah. Yeah.
Hey, man. Van Dyna, I fucked up. I stabbed your partner. I didn't... take me...
Liana Weston was my whole world. Not because of one crazy son of a bitch. She's gone forever. I'd like to take this opportunity to officially retire from police work. It has been a pleasure to serve with you, and I'll see you all in hell. Thank you. Goodbye, sweet angel.
Ron, wait. Oh.
How can you retire? You got the son of a bitch. You said it yourself. You got him.
No, you don't understand. That crazy son of a bitch was me.
Oh. Well, you gotta forgive yourself. Because everybody makes mistakes.
Man can only take so much, Scraps. Man can only take so much.
Mine is the only weapon that doesn't need a holster. Paul Blart. Mall cop.
Oh boy, do we have fun. That was a new partner, everyone. That's a great little web show that those guys made for Funny or Die back in like 2014 or something. And they've never quite hit. They did that movie I mentioned earlier, Deep Murder. It's really funny, but it's bizarre, absurd type of comedy. The shit that I like, clearly, and I play on the show a lot. I don't know if they have the mainstream appeal or whatever, but hopefully those guys are in something one day, because I think they're really talented. Josh Margolin's the main actor, and Quinn Beswick is the guy on crutches. And they're a writing duo and a production duo, and I admire them a lot. All right, that said, we're going to keep moving things forward with the show, because I hear thunder and lightning outside, and I don't want my power to go out in the middle of this. That could never happen. We're going to go right into our last live segment of the show. It's something we do every episode since pretty much the beginning. It's time for the top 10 list. Hells to the yeah. It's time for the top 10 list. Mother effers, you know what I'm talking about? All right, so we got a very special one this week. It is, interestingly enough, the top 10 things I did during the show hiatus. That's right, I had about a month and a half off in between seasons. That's usually how I decide one season ends and another one begins, is I'm like, oh, I have a break for work or just I got bored. So that's basically what we're doing this week. The top 10 things that I did during the show hiatus. Here we go, everybody. Coming in at number 10. I stayed inside. Yeah, hell yeah, I stayed inside. Why would I go anywhere when I don't have to? Top 10 things I did during the show hiatus. Number 9, slept a lot. Boy, did I sleep a lot, and I'm still doing it. Top 10 things I did during the show hiatus. Number 8, wrote my will. Always important to have a will, ladies and gentlemen. Top 10 things I did. Number 7, planned my suicide. Just the plan. Number 6, canceled my suicide. Wasn't such a good idea. You know, sometimes you get bored. Top 10 things I did. Number 5, vowed to write less dark material. And admittedly, that's not really my bag. Top 10 things I did during the show hiatus. Got my marriage annulled. It was about time. I didn't need that marriage anymore. Top 10 things I did. Number 3, remembered I was never married. I don't know why I thought I was. You think that's something you'd remember. Top 10 things I did. Number 2, whose marriage did I annul? Oh, what a crazy world I live in. And the top 10 things I did during the show hiatus. Number 1, I wrote this list. Yeah, we did it, everybody. That was the top 10 list. I just gotta remember to look at the damn camera, because it's above me. It's like, here's me looking at my screen. Ah, there's the camera. All right, let's check in on the stream and see how everybody's doing. Thank you, Marina, for jumping in. She's literally playing trivia at a bar right now, and she's like, hey, and said hi. So that's a fan right there, motherfucker. Someone's smoking. okay, anyways, we're going to keep things going, guys. We have one more playlist to show you. And what I like to do generally for the last playlist is focus on a sketch spotlight. So a sketch act or a group that I like to look at their body of work, and someone that I generally admire, and play some of their sketches that you might enjoy. So this week we're going to be doing Tim Robinson. Tim Robinson, he wrote for SNL for years. He got on for a couple sketches, but he was an oddball. He was like a Kyle Mooney. He was just a weird, weird dude. He ended up showing up on Netflix on The Characters, got his own show with Sam Richardson called The Detroiters, and the Netflix sketch show I Think You Should Leave. So these are all great things Tim Robinson has done. He has sort of a cult following now. And I thought I'd look at some of his work that he did, you know, pre-fame. If you can call it fame. I mean, you know, within Comedy Nerds, we think he's great. But yeah, let's take a look at this one. This will be a last play for the night. Check it out. Mr. Tim Robinson in Sketch Ahoy. Whatever. All right, let's go to this playlist. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Playlist, go.
Trash goes out on Tuesdays. Walk the dogs twice a day. To-do list on the fridge. I feel like I'm repeating myself.
You know what, man? Just go take care of your mom. I got everything covered here, okay?
Thank you.
Yeah.
This really means a lot. Oh, feel free to have a friend or two over, just no parties.
Oh, I won't have any parties.
Okay, good.
Cool.
Because yeah. I have neighbors on all sides and they have children, so you just can't get loud.
Oh! Won't be loud.
Yeah, I appreciate that. I have a landline.
Oh, sweet.
However, you cannot make any long-distance phone calls.
Oh, I won't make any long-distance phone calls.
What are you doing?
What do you mean?
Are you mocking me?
No, what do I mean mocking?
Well, you keep looking out and doing that thing with your eyebrows.
Oh, I'm not looking out and doing that thing with my eyebrows.
Do it again.
Dude, what again?
Man, I don't need this, okay? My mom is sick.
Oh, your mom's not sick.
Stop mocking me.
Oh, I'll stop mocking you.
Stop looking out.
Oh, I'll stop looking out.
I'm doing you a favor.
I'm doing you a favor letting you stay here. You don't have a home. You don't have a job.
Oh, I have a
job. Don't do it.
I didn't.
Stop getting mad at me.
No, I won't get mad at you.
Now look out.
What the hell was that, man?
Shut up.
What was that?
Shut up. Just watch my place.
I will.
All right.
Oh, I don't.
Don't.
I didn't.
It's really fun.
All right, yeah. Great. You guys ready to do this thing?
We didn't get scripts or anything.
Yeah, so like I don't know if I'm married to one of them or if they're like...
The way I like to make a porno is just you guys kind of improvise a few lines back and forth and we get straight to the sex.
That sounds hard. You gotta make up the lines.
Don't overthink it, you know, just kind of have fun with it. Just make a few choices, say a few lines back and forth and then let's just get straight to the sex, okay? Action.
So, what do you guys think? You want to both do me at once?
I wish I could. I can't. I gotta go to a huge business meeting. Super important.
Thanks for the reminder. I actually have a business meeting too. Mine's in a skyscraper. Where's yours?
Skyscraper.
Can I come with you guys to a business meeting?
Can't, son. Not old enough yet. Just to hear with your mom.
Whoa, okay, all right. Yeah, let's cut there.
Nice. It was awesome.
Really
yeah, what the hell was that, guys? Why are they leaving? Why are they not staying and having sex?
Well, after the business meeting, they would come back here and have sex. I did feel like my guy would get to go to the skyscraper.
I'm sorry.
No,
that's on me.
Drop the skyscraper stuff. Let's not be a family either, okay?
What if I come in on this one?
Yeah, whatever. As long as you come in, talk words, have sex. Action.
So we've got a few hours before my husband gets back from his business meeting.
What kind of building is his business meeting in?
In a skyscraper.
Move on.
Let's do it quick before your husband catches us.
Guys, you gotta help me. I'm a Mexican guy and 10 racist whites are chasing me. They're trying to hate crime me. I think I got a minute though if you wanna do it.
Okay, cut.
That was awesome. I think we need to explore this choice here. Show the outside. Show the racist whites out there.
You can't be Mexican. You're clearly a very white man. How about we do this? You just say whatever you would say before you have sex as yourselves, okay? Action.
Are you guys super hard right now?
No, I did another porno this morning, so I'm exhausted.
What about you? Are you super hard?
No. Thinking about my kids.
You got kids?
Yeah.
What ages?
Oh, yeah. 8 and 6.
Oh, I got
cut. No, you know what? Changed my mind. Let's not be ourselves. Let's be a character, something really far away from you. You're in a fantasy. You're just be something that's not you. Action.
Welcome to the castle, knight. Do you want to take off your armor?
Yes, my queen. First of all, let me ask you, what floor of this tall castle are we on?
Oh, I don't know. What floor are we on, loop player? Ooh.
Time out. I can't do castle accent. I can't do that accent.
The castle's not going to work at all because it's set in the modern day. You guys have modern costumes on. You just pull in an iPhone.
Boz Luhrmann bends those rules.
We're going to do this. You're going to say, like, I don't know, like eight words. And then you're going to fuck. Action.
You guys wanna fuck?
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's two more? Skyscraper.
No, cut! God damn it!
But I'm actually hard right now.
Yeah, that worked.
That was awesome.
No, it was not good at all. It was horrible.
Why don't you just tell us what you want us to say? What do you say before you have sex?
It's too private. I'm not gonna say that.
Why? What do you say?
I don't know, okay? I don't know what people say before sex.
What?
Just say one thing you said before you had sex before you said.
The last time you said. I'm a virgin.
What?
You're a virgin?
You direct porns and you're a virgin?
I'm the virgin porn director. And this is my story.
I think it's still our story.
Yeah. Sleeping.
He looks so peaceful, you know?
Yeah, he looks peaceful.
Yeah, he's small.
Yeah, he's tiny, right?
So small.
Such a tiny. Honey, can I ask you something? You have to promise not to hate me. You have to promise.
I would never hate you. What?
Is our baby ugly?
Oh my god, yes!
Right?
Yes!
No, but I mean really, really ugly.
No, yeah, it looks like a miniature elf covered in like a rusty Brillo pad.
Yeah, it looks like the spawn of a hobo leprechaun and an eagle.
Yeah, yeah.
In Mommy and Me class this week, I pretended to be his nanny.
What?
Yeah, I was like, El niño es muy feo.
Why did you speak Spanish? That's so racist.
Because I always get racist when I feel cornered. You know that.
Yeah, I know. Well, the other day, Dave from accounts came in my office, and he picked up the picture I have of him, and he started laughing.
Jesus!
Yeah, I told him the picture came with the frame. He was like, it looks like a retarded Michael Rappaport mixed with an inbred little orphan Annie.
God, Dave is such an asshole.
Yeah, but look at him.
He's a super accurate asshole.
Dead on.
Well, I think it was the way he was conceived.
What?
He was a butt baby.
What are you talking about?
Remember that night we were drinking a lot and you missed? And finally I was like, wrong hole, and you put it in the right hole and I got like a horrible yeast infection. That's not the point. He started as a butt baby.
Okay, but I have something to confess. That wasn't an accident.
What?
That wasn't an accident. I did that on purpose, and then you freaked out and I pretended like it was an accident. This is my fault. And what are we gonna do, lie to people until he looks better?
He's not gonna look better, okay? I think he's always gonna look like a ferret fucked up.
A patch of dog piss grass.
Yes!
Yeah, and like, his body's gonna be like a combination of like a naked E.T.
Oh, right? but like an adult with midget features.
Yeah, like a full-grown adult.
Full-grown man. It's like, we'll
tell him. No matter what school he goes to or like how much money he makes, he's always gonna like kind of seem like trash.
Yeah. He'll kind of talk like that, so he's like just like stupid and retarded, or like a ratchet off my tongue.
Yeah, I don't talk like that.
No. You do talk like that.
No, I don't. I don't talk like that.
Why are you making dead eyes right now? Okay, listen. This is our son, you know, and we're gonna love him no matter what.
Yeah, so maybe we'll just have to, like, you know, push him in a direction where
He can follow a dream where it doesn't matter what he looks like. Like one of those guys who builds fuck robots.
Or a stay-at-home dad.
Yeah. Let's go to bed.
Okay. Don't get that ding-dong anywhere near me until you snip the ugly drip from your fug balls, okay?
Or we could just tie up your fucking dog tubes. I'll talk about it in the morning.
Okay. I love you.
I love you. I love you. Good.
Don't.
Okay, yeah, I wasn't gonna.
Don't do that.
He just looked a little cold.
Okay.
We should see what
you go first.
Okay.
This is Saunders?
Yes.
Yes, what?
Yes, I am her.
Thank you. Say the whole thing. Jeez. Well, the surgery was a success. We're lucky your husband got here so quickly after the accident. We were able to stabilize him eventually, but in order to save his life, I had to take his neck.
Okay. No, not okay. I don't understand. He lost his neck?
Well, we didn't lose it. It's in the garbage. I'd show you, but it's probably got fries on it by now, you know?
I guess if this was some sort of last-ditch effort to save his life...
Yep. Yeah. That's it. It's a last-ditch thing to save his life. What we had to do is we had to make two very small, imperceptible incisions right here in the neck so we could get in there with a power saw and just jam away on that bad boy. Then just dunk the sucker in the trash.
Oh my God.
Don't cry.
Okay, when I see him, he's not gonna have a neck.
He'll be neckless, completely neckless. You wanna see the freak or what are we doing here? I shouldn't joke, I'm sorry. Do you wanna see your husband?
Yeah, I'd like to see my husband.
Yeah.
Danny.
Hey, sweetie.
You okay?
Sweetie.
He can walk, by the way. I didn't mess that up.
Yeah, they said I should be wheeled out so I don't fall.
It's a bit dramatic, isn't it? All right, let me tell you about your new body here. It's gonna take some getting used to. First of all, we're lucky that the shoulders aren't rejecting the head. So the head still has full access to all this stuff right here. Your chest, tummy, all the way down to your big old hog. Which works fine, by the way. Look at her, she's going, thank you very much, Docie. I'm going, don't thank me yet, he can't munch your box anymore.
Oh my God, okay, mostly I think we're just worried about, well, I'm wondering if I could free.
You gotta tell the FBI about your new height, in case there's ever a manhunt for you. Snipers will be like, pew! What the, I thought he was this tall. Other than that, my nurse Christy's gonna give you some literature that should answer any other questions you should have. Christy! What are you doing back there? I said you're not allowed back there.
I could go back there if I want to.
Fine.
Here you go. You're going to want to read this.
That's Christy. I delivered her baby last year. She almost didn't make it. I had to rip her neck off to save her. The baby, too.
But now she's a happy, healthy four-year-old.
Yep.
Why do you have a picture of her in your waiting room?
It's covering up a safe.
Well, glad I'm alive, at least.
Random! Yeah, you two lovebirds gotta get on out of here, okay? I'm up to my hog and balls and paperwork.
Do we come back for physical therapy?
Uh-uh! No, you don't ever come back here, you hear me? We're moving, at the end of the day, today, to a new space, bigger. Big old dusty place, hey! You just check completely out! I say one thing about myself and it's just...
Sorry, mister.
Oh, it's fine. Honestly, I'm starving though. You guys gotta go. I got another neck ripping off at 5. Or appendectomy, but hopefully I don't have to rip his neck off. Some evenings.
Hey, what's up? I'm Joanna from Above Average. Listen, don't click for more videos, do not click subscribe, and definitely don't tap here for more videos from Above Average. I'm so sorry. I lied just now. Please do click because it is how I get money for food.
And we're back, everyone. That was Tim Robinson, and boy, has he done some crazy shit. He plays a lot of assholes and some dumb guys, but you know, he's America loves him. One of our favorites right now, North America. We're part of America, America Junior. Whatever. Anyways, guys, thank you for hanging out with me. This is the end of the show now. This concludes all the fun stuff that I had planned for you today. And we will be back next week and continuing on. And look at this. I almost hit my hour and a half mark. That's very good. It's just about 10:30. I'm going to get you guys out of here a couple minutes before so you can, you know, beat the traffic and all that fun stuff. And tell everyone that I'm funny and worth hanging out with and watching and laughing at. Does that sound good? All right, bye. We will see you next week. Peace out. And I'll, yep, bye.